I Ευλογητός ο Θεός ημών πάντοτε νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Αμωμή εν οδό, αλληλούια. Ευλογητός η Κύριε διδαξών με τα δικαιώματά σου. Αλληλούια. My soul has grown tired from sorrow. Strengthen me with your word. Alleluia.
Incline my heart to your testimonies and not to love of gain. Alleluia.
Despondency took hold of me because of sinners who forsake your law. Alleluia.
I am a partner with all those who fear you and who keep your commandments. Alleluia.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιώ και Αγίω Πνεύματι.
Ευήν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We pray to you, hear us and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
We pray for the repose of the soul of the sleeping servant of God, Emmanuel, and for the forgiveness of his every offense, whether deliberate or unintended.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
That the Lord our God may place his soul where the righteous dwell. For the mercies of God, the kingdom of the heavens, and the remission of his sins, let us ask of Christ, our immortal King and God.
Lord, have mercy.
For you are the resurrection, the life, and the repose of your sleeping servant, Emmanuel. O Christ, our God, and to you we offer glory. With your eternal Father and your holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and forever, into the ages of ages.
Amen.
Εχείρε σου επίσαν με και πλάσαν με, συνέτησον με και μαθήσω με τα σέντολα σου, ελέησον με Κύριε.
Have mercy on me, O Lord.
I belong to you, save me, for I have sought your precepts. Have mercy on me, O Lord.
From your decisions I did not turn away, for you have given me the law. Have mercy on me, O Lord.
I have inclined my heart to follow your precepts forever in recompense. Have mercy on me, O Lord.
It is time for the Lord to act, for they have dispersed your law. Have mercy on me, O Lord.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιώ και Αγίω Πνεύματι.
Αιώνας των αιώνων, αμήν. Ελέησονε, Κύριε.
Και ελέησον με, αλληλούια. Look upon me and have mercy on me, according to your decision, for those who love your name. Alleluia.
I am young and count as nothing, yet I have not forgotten your judgments. Alleluia.
Hear, Hear my voice, O Lord, in your mercy, and according to your decision, give me life. Alleluia.
Rulers have pursued me without cause, and my heart has been fearful of your words. Alleluia.
My soul shall live and praise you, and your decisions will help me.
I have gone astray like a sheep that is lost. Seek your servant, for your commandments I have not forgotten.
Blessed are you, O Lord, teach me your precepts. The choir of the saints has found the fountain of life and the gateway of paradise. May I also find the path through repentance. I am the sheep that is lost. O Savior, call me back and save me. Blessed are you, O Lord, teach me your precepts. I am an image of your inexpressible glory. Though I bear the scars of my failings, in your loving kindness, Master, have compassion and cleanse the person you have formed. Grant me the homeland for which I yearn, making me again a citizen of paradise. Glory to the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Let us devoutly raise our voice in praise of the threefold radiance of the one God. Holy are you, Eternal Father, co-eternal Son, and Divine Spirit. Illumine us who worship you in faith, and rescue us from the eternal fire. Alleluia, 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 glory to you, O God.
Alleluia, 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 doxa si, O Theos.
Alleluia, 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 pleasure in life ever remains unmixed with sorrow. What glory stands on earth unchanged? All are more feeble than a shadow, all more deceptive than dreams. One moment and death supplants them all, but in the light of your countenance, O Christ, in the sweetness of your beauty, give rest to the one whom you have chosen as friend of humanity.
As a flower withers and as a dream passes, so everyone comes to an end. Yet at the sound of the trumpet, all the dead as in an earthquake will rise to meet you, Christ our God. Do then, Master, place the spirit of your servant, whom you have taken from us in the dwellings of your saints.
All human things are vanity. Those that do not subsist after death, riches do not remain, nor does glory travel with us on the way. For when death comes, all these vanish away. Therefore, let us cry out to Christ, the immortal King. Give rest to the one who has departed from us in the dwelling place where all rejoice.
Truly awesome is the mystery of death, how the soul from the body is parted by force from its harmony, and this natural bond of union by divine will is severed. Therefore we implore you, give rest to the departed one in the tents of your righteous, O giver of life and loving God.
I remembered the prophet crying out, I am earth and dust. And again I looked at the tombs, considered the naked bones, and asked myself, who is this? King or soldier, rich or poor, righteous or sinner? Give rest among the righteous to your servant, O Lord, as friend of humanity.
My beginning and my substance came from your command that fashioned me, for it was your will to form me into a living creature from nature both visible and invisible. From the earth you formed my body, by your divine and life-giving breath you gave me a soul. Therefore, O Christ, give rest to your servant in the land of the living, in the tents of the righteous.
Ανάπαυσον σωτήριμον ζωδόταν, ον μετέστησας αδελφών ημών εκ των προσκέρων, κράζοντα δόξα σοι.
I mourn and I lament when I contemplate death, and I see a beauty that was made in the image of God, lying in the graves disfigured, without glory and without form. What a perplexing thing! What is this mystery that has come upon us? How have we been given to decay and yoked together with death? Truly, as it is written by the command of God, who grants rest to the departed.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίω Πνεύματι, Your death, O Lord, became the agent of immortality. For had you not been laid in the tomb, paradise would not have been opened. Therefore, give rest to the departed one as friend of humanity. Kingdom, remember us, O Lord. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted.
Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth.
Blessed are those who hunger.
Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy.
Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God.
Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God.
Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of things against you falsely on my account.
Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven.
Ever blessed be the way on which you walk today, for there has been prepared for you a place of attentive.
To you, Lord, will I cry, O my God.
Wisdom.
The reading is from Paul's first letter to the Thessalonians.
Let us be attentive.
Brothers and sisters, we would not have you ignorant concerning those who are asleep, that you may not grieve as others do who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have fallen asleep. For this we declare to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, shall not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a cry of command, with the archangel's call, and with the sound of the trumpet of God. And the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so we shall always be with the Lord.
Peace be with you, the reader.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Wisdom, let us stand. Let us hear the holy gospel. Peace be with you all.
And with your spirit.
The reading is from the Gospel according to John. Let us be attentive.
Glory to you, Lord, glory to you.
The Lord said to those who believed in him, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me shall not hunger, and whoever believes in me shall never thirst. All that the Father gives me will come to me, and whoever comes to me I will not cast out. For I have come down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of him who sent me. And the will of him who sent me is this, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given me, but raise it up at the last day.
Glory to you, Lord. Glory to you.
Ελέησον ημάς ο Θεός κατά το μέγα ελέος σου, δεόμεθα σου επάκουσον και ελέησον.
Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον.
Έτι δεόμεθα υπέρ αναπαύσεως της ψυχής του και κοιμημένου δούλου του Θεού Εμμανουήλ και υπέρ του συγχωρηθήνε αυτό. Παν πλημέλημα εκούσιονται και ακούσιον.
Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον.
Όπως Κύριος ο Θεός τάξει την ψυχήν αυτού εν θα οι δίκαιοι αναπαύονται, τα ελέη του Θεού την βασιλεία των ουρανών και άφεσιν των αυτού αμαρτιών, παρά Χριστό το αθανάτο βασιλεί και Θεό ημών ετισόμεθα.
Κύριε ελέησον.
O God of spirits and of all flesh, you have trampled down death, made the devil powerless and given life to your world. Grant rest, Lord, to the soul of your sleeping servant Emmanuel, in a place of light, in a place of green pasture, in a place of refreshment, where there is no pain, sorrow, or sighing. As a good and loving God, forgive every sin which he may have committed in word, deed, or thought, for there is no one who lives and does not sin. You alone are without sin, your righteousness endures forever, and your law is truth.
For you are the resurrection, the life, and the repose of your sleeping servant, Emmanuel, O Christ, our God. And to you we offer glory, together with your eternal Father and your all-holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Δόξα σοι ο Θεός ημών, δόξα σοι.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίω Πνεύματι, και νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Πάτερ Αγίε ευλογήσον.
Ο και νεκρόν και ζώντο την εξουσίαν έχωρον σ' αθάνατος βασιλεύς και αναστάς εκ νεκρών, Χριστός ο αληθινός Θεός ημών, τες πρεσβείες της Παναχράντου, Αγίας αυτού Μητρός, των Αγίων ενδόξων και πανεφήμων Αποστόλων, των Οσίων και Θεοφόρων Πατέρων ημών, των Αγίων ενδόξων προπατώρων Αβραάμ, Ισάκ και Ιακώβ, του Αγίου και Δικαίου Φίλου αυτού Λαζάρου του Τετραημέρου και πάντων των Αγίων, την ψυχήν του εξημών μεταστάντος δούλου αυτού, Εμμανουήλ, εν σκηνές δικαίων τάξεν, κόλπης Αβραάμ αναπαύσε και με τα δικαίων συναριθμίσε, ημάς δε ελέησε ως αγαθός και φιλάνθρωπος. Eternal be the memory, eternal be the memory, eternal be his memory. Eternal be the memory. Eternal be the memory, eternal be his memory.
Διευχών των Αγίων Πατέρων ημών, Κύριε Ιησού Χριστέ ο Θεός, ελέησον και σώσον ημών. A certain motorist driving through the countryside felt he was lost. He came across a farmer, pulled over and said, "I need help. I'm lost." The farmer looked at him and then said, "Do you know where you are?" The traveller said, "Yes, I saw the name of the town as I entered." The farmer said, "Do you know where you want to go?" "Yes," the traveller replied, and he named his destination. The farmer looked away for a moment and then quipped back, "You ain't lost. You just need directions." Now let's apply this analogy to this moment. We Christians know who we are. We consider ourselves children of our Heavenly Father. And quoting the Bible, whom God so loved that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him might not perish, but have life everlasting. We are the ones to whom Jesus said, "Do not fear, little flock. It is your Father's good will to give you the kingdom." We know that that's talking about us, the Christians, the believers. We know where we are. We are in a world created by God. We have been placed here. We stand in the middle of his love in enjoying the world around us. But the body we live in, this temporary thing we call the body, is like a tent. Apostle Paul says in the second letter to the Corinthians, "If the earthly tent we live in is destroyed, that's okay. We have a building from God, a house not made with hands, but eternal in the heavens." By calling this body an earthly tent, it refers to the coming and going, the transience of life, that it doesn't last long. No one ever lives permanently in a tent. Our earthly life is short. The body is frail and weak. And like a tent, so easily buffeted by the problems of life and so easily destroyed. And so we are led to the next point. We know who we are, we know where we are, and we as Christians also know where we are going. Quoting the Bible again, "I go to prepare a place for you," said Jesus. "In my Father's house, there are many dwellings." Through death, this gateway we call death, the committed Christian exchanges an earthly tent for a permanent home with God in a place where eyes have not seen what things God has prepared for those who love him. Our purpose on earth is not to adorn the tent with as many ornaments or trinkets as we can, but to walk with Jesus. So that when moving day comes, may I use that phrase, he will take us by the hand and lead us to heaven. So, knowing who we are, where we are, and where we are going, we Christians are not lost when we face the death of a loved one. We just need directions. And those directions are provided by the Lord Jesus himself. Come to me, all you who labor and are heavily burdened, and I will give you rest. I am the resurrection and the life. God has not guaranteed us a certain number of years in this world. No one knows how long we shall live. For some more, some less, we don't know. But what has been guaranteed to those who love him is that they shall live forever. Amen. Dear friends,
it is with great sadness that we are gathered here today. However, in the true spirit of Emmanuel Barabudas, we are here to celebrate the wonderful and inspiring story of a truly special man. Some of you may know him as Manoli, and some of you may know him as Guli. When I was a baby, when I started to learn how to speak, I made up a word and used to call him Baba Guli. As I grew older, instead of cutting off the Guli, I cut off the Baba. And until this day, he was always my Guli. He was more than a father to me. He was my mentor, my best friend, and loved me unconditionally. I love my father so much, and I admire him to this very day. Even being in a wheelchair, my father was very strong-willed, independent, and never gave up, no matter what. Not only was he funny, but he was very smart. He even enrolled himself in a computer course 5 years ago after... Sorry, I can't see. After my beautiful mum passed away, and I'm ashamed to say that he was so much better using the internet and Facebook than myself. I would always ask him questions about the internet, and he would always laugh and tell me to go and enroll in the computer course like him. He was also known as a gourmet cook. Everyone loved his cooking. I would always ask him what was in the recipe. He would look at me and laugh and say it was my secret. Manoli was born in Cairo, Egypt, on the 25th of June, 1937. But the true story is his mother changed his year of birth, so he wouldn't have to go to the army. In fact, we don't even know the month or day he was born. But he was born in 1936. Manoli was the third child to Anna and Themistocles Barabudas, and beloved brother to Kiki, Dimitri, who passed away when he was a young child, and Mary, who also passed away about 30 years ago. Manoli had a happy upbringing full of adventure and cheekiness. Like this story, my Thea Kiki and Kuli were having dinner, and when they were little, this happened. They used to be cheeky with each other and tease each other while eating dinner. One night, when Thea Kiki got up and walked away after being cheeky, Kuli got his fork and threw it at her direction, And to both her surprises, it landed in her calf and got stuck to the point that the fork was shaking. All they did was laugh, and my auntie has the scars to this day to prove it. His cheekiness and ability to make people laugh runs in the family. We all know Quilly, like his late wife, my mum Maria, loved all animals, especially the dogs, to death. Billy, Lily, Ringo, Chanel, Arnie, and of course the love of his life, Honey Bear, who we all know I should have been the love of his life, but I'll get over it one day, I hope. He started an amazing bond with her. He shared an amazing bond with her. In fact, we all know that he loved her more than me and used to threaten me that he would leave everything to her in his will if anything happened to him. I haven't read the will yet, so it might happen. Quilly also had a passion for fashion. He always styled to perfection, and during his career as a hairdresser, he was always in a three-piece suit and always had the best perfumes on him and smelt amazing. Quilly was a handsome and classy 26-year-old man about the town who was already much in demand by the ladies when he first met my mum. As soon as he laid eyes on her, he was smitten and knew she would be the last woman he ever pursued, and she would become the love of his life. They got engaged after 3 months and not much later got married on the 21st of April 1963, when Quilly was 27 years old. A whirlwind romance, however, inspirational story proving that love can blossom quickly and last a lifetime. Quilly and Mum came to Australia by boat from Cairo. The 30-day journey was hard, however, they arrived safely in God's country, Sydney, Australia, on the 31st of December 1965. Quilly and Mum were always the strongest, most united couple and worked together in hairdressing for many years. On the 29th of April 1967, they had the first and only child, me. Once I came along, the strong, united team was complete. They loved me with all their heart, and my love for them is like no other. From early on, the Greek trio had a lot of fun together. A lot of teasing and joking filled our days and memories. I remember when my parents told me this one story. My mum used to go to the hairdressing shop in Kingsford every Saturday. One Saturday morning, my mum was running late. When one customer came downstairs, she saw her, spat at her, and called her a vroma. My mum was so confused that when she went up to the shop and told my dad what happened, as she was telling him, my dad was killing himself laughing. They always used to joke around. You could never tell if they were joking or being serious. This customer had asked my dad where my mum was that morning, and he said, "Oh my God, haven't you heard? I went home the other day and found her in bed with a black man." The customer was in complete shock and believed him, as my dad was so convincing. Even my mum laughed about the entire thing. There was another time when I was living at home and my dad was putting hairspray on his hair, so much hairspray, but he hardly had any hair. We were choking and coughing from the amount of hairspray. My mum said to him, "Vremanoli, why are you putting so much hairspray when you hardly have any hair?" He turned around without thinking and said, "Well, Maro, more, why do you wear a bra?" And they both cracked up laughing. Another fond memory I remember when I was young, we were watching the Don Lane show, and Marsha Hines was singing "Something Is Missing in My Life." And my dad turned around to me and said, "Effie, do you know why she's singing that song?" And I said, "No, why?" I was like about 4 or 5. "It's because her little finger got cut off and she's missing her little finger." Me, being a young girl, believed my dad because I always thought he was telling me the truth. Then a few years ago in my late 40s, I was watching the show, a show, and Marsha Hines was on it. I saw her fingers on her hands and asked Quilly, "Hey, Marsha Hines has all her fingers." And he replied laughing, "Vrechazo, did you really believe me?" And my mum was laughing with him. I grew up in the comedy team. If you knew Quilly, you would be familiar with his light-hearted and highly spirited and animated side. Quilly and Mum were married for a record 52 years. Until Mum's final days, the love was unique and powerful. You could see it in the eyes, which was rare these days. They did everything for each other, shared many passions, and had a great deal of fun together. The relationship is a shining example of the type of unconditional, almost fairy tale love that I admired and always wanted to have. What Quilly felt for his family can best be described by the Greek word kapsoura, meaning a strong burning desire of love. There is no doubt Quilly was a passionate man. He loved a good Greek song, Bouzoukia, dancing to all hours of the evening. And this is why you'll hear a song he requested me to play at the crematorium. Gulli possessed the rare quality that made everyone he met love him instantly, even to the point that where Regina and Ramos in their 40s asked my dad at 84 to be their gumbaro. And my dad was so excited. They even got married in this church. And my father was so honored at 84 when they could have asked someone their own age. He was cheeky, generous, and always lifted others up. He always made others laugh no matter how he was feeling. He was elegant all his life and he will forever be elegant. From the day he was born until now, other more recent members of the family, Elton and Raffi, gravitated towards him because of his childlike and cheekiness spirit. Raffi keeps talking about how cool he used to take her to restaurants and coffee shops. And she always loved it when Gulli took her for a ride in his electric wheelchair. He saw them as his grandchildren that he never had, including Emilia, Hugo, and more recently Archie. He absolutely loved them as he had the most contact with them. Every time he would see them, his face lit up like he won $1 million. In true Gulli style, rather than mourning him, we are here to celebrate his life. We are forever grateful for his enduring spirit and will remain in our hearts and memories for eternity.
Dear friends, just remain seated. You'll each row will be brought up a row at a time under the circumstances. We need to maintain a certain level of physical distancing, as you understand, and you'll come up to give your respects. The family will not be receiving the customary condolence line in the church, but we'll be seeing you at Botany. And then?
Eastern Suburbs. And then if you want to come past for a quick drink and then leave. We can't have more than 20 people at
That's
a time.
That's right. Yeah, we can't have too many people. So if you want to join us at Botany Cemetery at the crematorium, and then...
My place.
At your place.
Yeah.
Got it. Okay. Thank you.
And at the crematorium, I have a list because I'm only allowed a certain people in there. Please, if your name is not on the list, outside it's covered, there's screens, and you can hear everything.
Thank you.